HSBC says it has achieved a world-first breakthrough in deploying quantum computing in financial markets. The London-based bank used IBM's quantum processor to attain a 34% improvement in predicting bond trade prices. Let's bring in Robert Lea right now, senior analyst at Bloomberg Intelligence, for the details on this apparent breakthrough and what it could mean for banking. So, Rob, the head of quantum technologies at HSBC, telling Bloomberg he sees this potentially as a Sputnik moment for quantum.
Yes, I did see that. I think that's an interesting choice of words, and I think it's a very interesting development. But again, if you take a step back, any innovation, any new technology sort of follows a continuum, really. It sort of starts with that Archimedes moment in the bath, you know, the flash of inspiration. Then it goes into the research phase and then through to development and ultimately commercial deployment. So the reason I explain that is I think quantum computing is still very much at the research phase. So this is very much, a very interesting development. I suppose, again, looking at the headlines and HSB's announcement, what we don't know is if what they've achieved is repeatable, and is it scalable, and is it ultimately deployable at an affordable cost. So, for example, if you were to build a quantum computer in your living room, you would need state-of-the-art equipment that's probably only found in IBM labs or, you know, the labs of Imperial College and the like. It's incredibly complex, incredibly expensive. For example, you need to lower the temperature of these things down to literally very close to what is called absolute zero. You know, you need huge setups, you need superconducting technology. It's really, really difficult. So I think what we're seeing is an interesting step along the research path, but the commercial deployment of these things remains many, many years away.
Okay, so you can't just put one of these quantum computers next to or on a trading floor and expect that magic happens. What, given all of those questions and all those caveats that you underscore for us, Rob, what is your sense, what is your understanding as to when we start to get real practical applications for quantum?
Right, in my mind, keeping things very simple, you've probably heard of fusion power. These are power plants that are trying to replicate the conditions of the sun. If scientists and developers can crack that problem, then in theory, it would solve all the world's energy needs. In theory, it's unlimited power at a very, very low cost. Now, that is something really to gun for, something to aim for. Quantum computer is similar. These are two technologies with massive long-term promise, but they face considerable technological barriers, and we're nowhere near achieving commercial deployment on either of them. So again, at the research lab phase, businesses should continue to develop, but it goes back to the premise of risk-reward. The promise and the reward is potentially huge, but the risks and uncertainties relating to those, you need a real, Nobel Prize-winning development, and so trying to predict that is next to impossible. Will it happen in the next year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years? Who knows? So very, very interesting technologies, both of them, but based on what we do know, based on the facts, the commercial deployment of these technologies remains pretty distant, I think. That's a rational way to look at it.
Yeah. Okay, no, that's really interesting in terms of how to frame the timing of this and all the question marks over that. Rob, you're there in Hong Kong. To what extent is quantum computing and the race towards that end goal, whatever the time frame is a race between China and the US, or at least China and the West? And where does China stand? To what extent is this a geopolitical story as well?
Well, yeah, that's a very interesting question. It is, and if you look at China's strategic objectives, quantum computing is one area that the government has outlined of being of national importance. But again, it very much remains at a research phase. You know, it's government labs, private labs who are pursuing investments. Again, as far as I'm aware, there are no deployable quantum solutions in the China market at the moment. So absolutely, given their vast scale in resources, in a way, it is a bit of a two-horse race, again, between the US and China. But again, let's not forget people in Europe, people at Imperial College and elsewhere. There is a global development going on at the research phase at the moment.